API system. API strip represents a set of different biochemical tests, such as enzyme and fermentation tests. There are 20 separate microtubes on the API strip. Each tube contains dehydrated substrates for the biochemical test. The results are based on color changes observed within each tube after the incubation time. Each microtube consists of a tube and gilpule. The Enterobacteriaceae are all gram-negative as well as oxidase-negative, therefore the above two tests should always be performed prior to the API20E identification. Other characteristics common to Enterobacteriaceae is the fact that they grow in bile-containing media such as McConkey. Depending on the ability to ferment lactose, Enterobacteriaceae may be divided into two groups. Lactose fermenters that appear pink on McConkey medium, and lactose non-fermenters that appear colourless on McConkey medium. Preparation of bacterial suspension. Approximately 3 to 4 colonies of the unknown bacteria are taken from the agar culture. The colonies are transferred into 5 ml of saline solution. A cloudy suspension should be obtained. Setting up an API strip. The bottom of the tray of the API strip holder is filled with sterile water in order to prevent dehydration of the strip during the incubation time. Pasture pipette is used to inoculate the strip with bacterial suspension. Each of the tubes on the API strip is filled with the bacterial suspension from left to right. Some of the tubes need to be filled with the bacterial suspension right to the very top end, including capsule area. These tubes are marked in the box underneath the name CIT VP GEL. Some of the tubes are required to have oil added to the very top of the capsule. Usually sterile liquid paraffin or mineral oil is used. The oil not only excludes the air and introduces anaerobic conditions, but also stops end gaseous products of certain reactions to be released. These gaseous substances would react with other substances from adjacent tubes, and consequently they would affect the final results. These tubes are marked with the line underneath the name ADH, LDC, ODC, H2S, and URE. The strip is then incubated at 37 degrees for 18 to 24 hours aerobically. After the incubation time, most of the tests are ready to be read. However, there are a few tests which require additional reagents to be added to the capsules in order for the test to be developed and interpreted. Adding the reagents. The TDA reagent is added to the TDA capsule. The Voigt-Proskauer test requires two reagents, VP1 and VP2. Firstly, VP1 is added to the VP capsule. Secondly, the VP2 reagent is added to the VP capsule. It allows detecting bacteria that utilise glucose through the natural pathway. Acetoin is detected via colour change reaction with VP1 and VP2. The James reagent is added to the indole test capsule. Indole as an end product may be detected by the reaction with James reagent. Pink colour change indicates a positive reaction. Approximately 10 minutes is allowed for the reaction to develop and the API strip is ready to be read.